C'est donc le grand jour en Gambie.
It is the day, and Gambians are already in polling stations to choose their next president.
En l'occurrence, eh bien, ces citoyens, disais-je, se rendent depuis ce matin aux urnes pour élire le président. Très rapidement, pour planter le décor de cette élection à un tour, trois candidats sont...
Opposition leader Adama Barrow heads a coalition of seven political parties, and then another opposition candidate, Mama Kande, will face incumbent Yahya Jammeh, who has maintained a 22-year grip on power.
Et puis, Mama Kande du Congrès démocratique de Gambie. L'enjeu ici est de redresser...
The main issue at stake now is Gambia's economy, described by many analysts as isolated from the rest of the world. This election is about three candidates, 53 constituencies, 1,422 polling stations, and about 900,000 registered voters. We are getting reports from Gambia that internet connection has been cut off from that country. The candidates seem confident, however, about the ability to win. Watch them.
Nothing is going to happen there. This is not the first time we are conducting elections. They will not win. The country would move forward faster than we move in 22 years. But also, I'm proud of what I did in 22 years, because what I did in 22 years, the British colonialists couldn't do it in 400 years in the Gambia. Our election system is fraud, is fraud proof. You cannot rig our elections.
Our chances are great. People have shown of tremendous support. With that support, we are 100% plus that we are going to win, and with a bigger margin. Gambians have suffered for the past 22 years because we have somebody in power who want to stay in power by all means. We have somebody in power who is dictating everybody, and that's why we came as a force to challenge him.
Well, the Gambia has a very unique voting system. Instead of using ballot boxes like most countries do, they have marbles. Well, these marbles are dropped into what is called drums, not the ballot boxes you know of, designated for each candidate. And this system has been used in the country for six decades. A director of the Independent Electoral Commission in the country demonstrates how it is done.
Adama Barrow. That's the photo, and that's the symbol. And that's his election photo, and his symbol. One in gray, one in green, one in purple. And between this marble, it has to fall onto this bell, and it will ring. That's it. And you go out. The third one, profile filled by the tokens, it's the number of votes obtained by a candidate in that polling station. Here, for example, if you happen to filter and arrange the tokens, we have 13 votes.
We are proud. This is unique to Gambia. It was invented by the Gambian Public Works Department. We've been using these drums for, what, over 60 years now. 60 years. And it works very well for our electoral system.
Voilà, et puis la commission électorale gambienne.
Gambia's Electoral Commission has been brought to the spotlight due to fraud allegations, as the commission is usually accused of favoring Yahya Jammeh. The commission's chairman says they are independent. Let's watch him.
Our motto is fair play, integrity, and transparency. We are therefore very proud to categorically state that we live by that mantra. In that, contrary to what is being said and written about the IEC, our electoral system is second to none in terms of its transparency, credibility, fairness, and transparency. No one can rig it.